Oh, I hate my internet. We're not just talking about slow internet today. No, no. I'm going to show you how to recognize and deal with a very specific problem, ISP throttling. In other words, how your internet service provider intentionally slows down your connection. Before we get into it, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more tech tips and tricks. Much appreciated. Anyway, the main sign of ISP throttling is slow internet while doing specific activities. Downloading large files, playing online games, or streaming video content. Your internet was fine, and all of a sudden, it's barely dragging by. It can also be specific websites that suddenly perform like crap. Like if your YouTube is slow, but internet is fast. And if you're asking, why is my Wi-Fi so slow during peak hours, it could also be a sign. Though this is one of the more legitimate ISP throttling reasons. If your Wi-Fi is slightly slower in the evenings or during weekends, your ISP might simply be trying to even out all that bandwidth. This only becomes a problem if they start discriminating against specific users. Comcast actually went to court over this back in 2010 for targeting people that used peer-to-peer networking applications. A more legitimate reason could be that you're exceeding your data limit. Internet service providers have a right to throttle your connection based on data usage limits, as long as they're clearly mentioned in your contract, usually in the very small print. That said, if you have an unlimited data plan and you suspect ISP throttling, then that is a whole other issue. Oh, and by the way, this also caused a lawsuit before, so yeah, it ain't legal. Illegal activities from your side could also be an ISP throttling cause, yet more often than not, it's not because of something you did at all. Introducing paid prioritization. This basically means that companies pay ISPs to load their websites faster, leaving others to drag in the slow internet mud. There's no way such bullshit is legal, you might say. But alas, it is. At least in the US, such activities would be prohibited by the net neutrality law, but it was abolished back in 2017 and not yet restored. Now, there are serious talks of bringing it back, so perhaps this year will be the year? But whatever the reason, here's what you can do about the ISP throttling nonsense now. First things first, run a speed test. I recommend repeating it a few times per day to see if there's a pattern. Now, Wi-Fi speeds may fluctuate for other reasons, so make sure you run speed tests while connected to Ethernet too. Then look at your internet service contract. If you don't have it anymore, just ask your ISP for a copy. Check the speed and monthly bandwidth limits. If reality and the contract don't match, contact your ISP and demand for them to live up to your contract terms. Now, in case you're dealing with paid prioritization or you think you might be targeted as a P2P user, here's how to fix ISP throttling your internet. The solution lies in a tool, a virtual private network, aka a VPN. Such an app works by encrypting your traffic, so the only thing your ISP will see is that you're using a VPN. Well, that and how much bandwidth you're using in total. But this makes it nearly impossible for your internet provider to do paid prioritization or to discriminate against P2P users, since they can no longer track what you're actually doing online. Just a bit of advice, make sure to pick a fast VPN, otherwise you'll end up with an even slower speed than what you started with. To avoid slow speeds, make sure to go for a VPN that has at least the WireGuard protocol, or even better, an updated version of it. It will ensure the best possible speeds. NordVPN and their NordLynx protocol is a good example. It's actually the fastest VPN on the market right now. Anyway, I'll leave a couple of my best VPN for ISP throttling recommendations in the description. Feel free to check them out. You'll also help out the channel this way. By this point, you should understand what is ISP throttling and what you can do about it. But slow internet is not always your ISP's fault. If you want to know more, check out my video on how to fix slow Wi-Fi. Thanks for sticking around to the end. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time.